about the act of prostituting somebody is actually forcing somebody to drop his morals and or use his talents for the benefit of others. When you are prostituting yourself, you're using your own talents or your own throw away your own morals for your own benefits. A politician how throws away his own morals, his own vision of how he can make the world a better place just because it makes him more money. It's also prostituting his own values. And businessman how in fact throws away his morals in order to make more money for businesses and promote businesses he deep inside in his heart is against is also prostituting his talents and himself for financial gain. In contrary with the majority's opinions, and prostitutes is not necessarily a sex worker or a whore. There are many kinds of prostitutes. Some are more filthy than others. Because the root of the word is actually to put out, to sell yourself, but not necessarily in a bodily sense. In the sense of the flesh. By this last extent, you can also say that the police are prostitutes, since they are not always agreeing with the law. No matter that they are not agreeing with the law, they sell their own morals to enforce the status quo, because that's their duty, that's where they get paid for. So are the lawyers who are not 100% agree with the law but still enforce them because they are afraid that they lose their job. When you are doing your work, selling your own morals for financial or political gains or social status or like this, you are prostituting your own talents and your own morals, your own status, your own liability, your own belief ability, your own character, and you are nothing more than a prostitute how it's horny for money and horny for still holding his job even he betrayed his own gut feelings. Stand for something instead of standing for nothing. Don't be a person of this time. Don't be a person of the past. Be a person of the future. Be a person with fire, not a person of success. Be a person who stands for righteousness, not one who stands for self-righteousness. Being a person who is not blinded by his own arrogance, greed and selfishness. And his whole hubris. Being a person who are standing against systematic oppression. The majority is not right just because it's the majority. Sometimes the majority is wrong as Hitler and the Nazis. Sometimes the majority of the legal persons was wrong, like the slave masters, who were considered the only legal persons in the time of slavery. Others, blacks, were not considered people or legal people in the town. They were chattel property according to the US laws of that time. And so are, sadly enough, still animals in this damn delusional time. Even animals are sentient and aware to the degree that we are claimed to be. According to the Cambridge Declaration of Consciousness, in all ways that are important are animals and our species, Homo megalomania extrema, so I prefer to call our species, and other animals the same kind of awareness, have the same kind of awareness. Furthermore, when comes the day that we stop having to debate questions of logic and compassion and decency for thousands, trillions, decades, maybe more than thousands decades of time to obtain the obvious truth that animals are not here to serve us, just like women do not been here to be raped by disgusting, filthy, perverted men, just like blacks in America were not made for the white man, just like whites are not made for the jihadist Muslims to be killed or used in crazy sacrificing rituals on some native tribal people. So our Indians are not here to be slaves of Arabs, Muslims, etc., etc., etc. If you are not willing to extend decency to other living beings, I ask you serious, why should you ask for it yourself? This world should not be ruled by the ruthless and heartless. This world shall be ruled by the ones who can distinct right from wrong. This world should be ruled by vegans who are vegan because of ethical reasons, the true and honest only reason you can be considered a vegan. Since veganism is far beyond what you eat, veganism is a lifestyle that seems to eliminate as much as reasonable possible the harm to other animals. And that includes at least to not wear them or use them for entertainment or eat them. Would drink their secretions, would just make for their babies. People, people, people. Stop being such actors. Become true humane and civilized. Stop playing political games. You non-vegans will not win this battle. Sadly, it can take decades maybe of time to obtain the obvious. This is very sad for the victims. But you are probably knowing, if you for one moment stop being a selfish, pathetic cunt and watch it from the position of the victims. Animals are victims, the most oppressed ever. 70 billion land and 2.8 trillion marine animals any year. That is more than the entire population of your myopic species. From the entire hominid history. By the way, your species. So, please, can we start to become sane again? Can we please be rational and extend our compassion to all innocent living beings instead of be a satiric, barbaric parasite to other living beings and share this world with other living beings? Ten thousand years ago, some 99% of all the animals on this planet, all the biomass, was wild animals. Just 1% was our species. Today, it's the direct opposite. The animals we enslave, but people who eat animals and their secretions and use them for exploitation. Occupy around 98% of the biomass, with wild animals only existing out of some 2% of the biomass. Why? We're destroying the rainforest as a species to make place for animal agriculture. 70% of all the deforestation, at least in the Amazon rainforest, is because of cattle ranching. At least 91% 91% of all the deforestation total in that place of the world, and also in other places of the world, largely, is cattle ran as an animal agriculture. It's total terrorist organization. And why do not the environmental agencies focus on that issue instead that they focus cars and logging, which in the case of animal agriculture's fossil fuel is for the environmental impact of the car industry is, and all forms of transportation actually together, is 14%. Animal agriculture is at least 51%. World Watch Institute . I have the link in the description below if you will check that out. And logging is around 1 to 3% of the deforestation. Yes, that is something, but it is in comparison to the huge environmental damage of the animal agriculture industry. Is that nothing? This comes not even close. So, you call yourself an environmentalist and you're not vegan? You can better call yourself a sarcasm or a joke. Because there does not exist something as a meat, dairy and egg eating and even leather wearing environmentalist. Check out my video about leather. Mate, and how much that destroys local water supplies in third world countries, because that's where the most of the leather is produced because of environmental laws how are not good enforced in such countries because their governments are corrupt to the hell and are hornies of the horny cronies of our governments. So, start to be a person of Viral is that of a person of success. Stand for what you stand for. Be an inspiration. Be the change. Stop be a politician. Because politicians don't change this world. Activists do. Politicians are there only to take the credits. When darkness and light become one, the reality splits away and the truth becomes visible.